Hi, my name is Westbam, and today, not a lame tutorial, but a funny little project, we're gonna make a clock. I saw they did this at the beginner's workshop at Node 2013, and well, it covered a lot of areas, so it's a fun way to learn some VVV. In the first part, we're gonna make this clock, and in the second part, I will show you how to simplify this, and make it look ace using some real clock textures. Okay. For now, I middle mouse click and make a new patch, and I drag this all aside because we're gonna rebuild it, and I'm gonna move my patch over here, and then I'm gonna scale it a bit, and then I press Ctrl Y to get an hair inspector. Now let's scale it up, and let's patch our clock. Well, my clock is going to be round, so we can use either a double left click segment, DX9, or we can use a sphere, and today I'm going to use the sphere because it's more easy to make it round. If I middle mouse click on the layer output, I get a group node, and if I middle mouse click here, I get my renderer. So I'm going to put my renderer over here and scale her up a bit. I'm going to put these two nodes down here because it's the last of our pipeline. And now the circle is looking rather ugly, but to fix that, I'm gonna select the sphere, and here in resolution Y, or here in this pin, I'm gonna change the resolution, and 32 makes a nice circle. I'm going to scale and move this circle later. So for now it's okay. I'm gonna make one more note for this circle, HSV, UV saturation value color join, and connect it to the color of the sphere, and I make the value a bit lower so our circle becomes a bit darker so we can see the clock hands and the numbers a bit better. Now let's make some clock hands, and we're gonna start with the hours. This will be just a quad DX9, and we connect it to the group node, and now we're gonna make another node, the transform 2D, because we need to scale it down a lot to make it look more like a clock hand. So connect the transform to the transform pin of the quad, not to the texture transform, but to the transform pin. And let's make it very narrow. So we're gonna scale X down. I just right click and drag down to make it smaller. I think this looks good. We also gonna scale the Y down a lot. And I'm gonna go below 0.5. It's shorter than half of our circle because it's the hours clock hand. I think I make it 0.35 for now. Now the way to rotate this clock hand is to simply change the rotate pin on the transform node. So if I right click and drag up or down, you see that the clock hand is rotating. And you also see that it rotates around its center point. Now there are two pins here, center X, center Y. Now and if I put the center Y to minus 0.5, I just right clicked and typed the value, and then clicked away, and I now rotate it. You see it rotates around the center of our clock, and this is perfect. Now let's make an IO box integer to test our rotation. I double right click and I pick integer, and if I now right click and drag on our IO box, I only get integers. And if I make a IO box value advanced and right click on it, I get all the values in between, so we need an IO box integer. I left click and delete this. Now, one rotation of the clock is a value from 0 to 1. Well, this IO box represents hours, and we have 12 hours in one circle, so I have to divide this value by 12. So I double left click, type in the divide symbol, and pick divide value. So we're gonna divide our IO box integer by 12. So I just right click here, type in 12 and click away. And if I now connect this output to the rotate, and if I now rotate the hours, you will see that there are 12 hours in one rotation. Now you also see that we are rotating the wrong direction. And the easy way to fix this is not to divide by 12, but to divide by minus 12. So I right click here and type in minus 12. And if I now rotate the clock, we're going the right way again. Okay, our first clock hand is done. So on to the minutes. And that's basically exactly the same. So I'm just gonna select all these nodes and hit Ctrl D to duplicate. And as you can see, the copy is still selected, so I can move all the notes in one go to the right. And now I want to connect the quad to the group note. But as you can see, our group note has no more free pins. Now, if I select the group note and I look at here in Spectre, you see layer template count, it's set to 2. So I'm gonna change it to 5 because I need at least 5 groups for this. And here you see we got 3 extra free pins. So now I can connect my quad. And let me do some housekeeping. I select this IOBox integer and I give it a descriptive name in here in Spectre. So I double left click and type in hours because these represent the hours. I select it, double left click, and these are the minutes. There are not 12 minutes in an hour, but there are 60. So I need to divide it by minus 60. And since these are the minutes, I'm gonna make it even smaller and a bit longer, so you can tell the difference a bit better. Okay, on to the next thing, the minutes. I select all the notes again, hit Ctrl D to duplicate, move them aside, connect the quad to the group note, and this is gonna be a bit longer. Exactly 0.5 will do. And we make it even smaller. And if I now rotate the minutes, you will see our clock is almost done. I think I make it even smaller. And of course, I select the IO box and type in seconds. Next, it's time to make some numbers around our clock. I could type 1 to 12, but let's make VVV do this for us. I'm going to create an I spread, so I double left click, type in the I, and pick the I spreads. And this will generate a spread of integers for me. So we're going from 1 to 13. And if you look in our inspector, we got 1 to 12, and that's exactly what we need. Now, we're gonna show this on our renderer, so I need a text node. So I double left click and type in text. And I connect my text to the last free group. The default text is VVVV, and that's this pin over here. So let's connect our iSpread. But that's not really working because the iSpread outputs values and the text accepts strings. So we need to find a way to change the format of the values into strings. And there is one node that does this, and that's the sString value. And if I now connect the iSpread to the sString value, and I connect the xString the text, you see there are a lot of zeros in our text, and that's not exactly what we're looking for. Well, that's just the way the S string is formatting the values to strings. And if I right click here, I get a whole list of enumerations, and I need to find the integer because we want to show just the whole values or the integers, and this looks better. Now, to make these strings form a nice circle around our clock, I need to transform my text, so I'm going to make a transform 2D, connect it to my text. Let's move it all down a bit. And since we're going to transform it in a circle, I'm going to make a circular spread. I'm going to connect the output X to the translate X, the output Y to the translate Y. We need a spread count of 12 because we got 12 strings now. And we need to scale down these numbers, so let's right click and drag down. And I'm just trying to make this look good, it is not really science. Now, and as you can see, the letters are placed a bit off. They're going the wrong direction, so the easiest way to fix that is we're going to reverse this iSpread, so it's going to be from 12 to 0. This looks better, but the 12 is still wrong. We can fix that by changing the face pin of the circular spread until the 12 is on top. 0.25 will do. And here we have our basic clock. Now, there is one other little cool note, and that's the spell value. And if you look at the help file, you'll see that it does. And if you right click on the mode, you can see in what ways we can spell out these values. So I'm gonna pick Roman, and I'm gonna feed it again with the iSpread. And I'm going to put the output on a little text node. Now we got a Roman styled clock, and I think it looks pretty neat. So we can delete the S string. Before I'm going to introduce the time, there's one more little problem I have. Let's say it's 3 hours and 30 minutes. And yet the hours clock hand is exactly on the 3 and it should be past the 3. So how we can fix that is simply divide the minutes through 12 and add that to our hours pin. So I'm going to divide this value by 12. And I'm going to make a add value node and simply edit the minute rotation divided by 12 to the hours rotation. And then I connect this to the rotate pin and I think it looks better now. And if I now move the minutes pin, the hour pin will also move. So we fix that, that's nice. Let's move this all down a bit. Now, one more thing before we're going to introduce the time. It's the seconds pin. And if I move the seconds, it goes a bit harsh. And I want to use a little damper node for that. Even more housekeeping. Oh, you notice what happened? I also selected the line and I moved the nodes. But the line didn't move. And that's how it should work. And that's a very handy feature inside VVV. I'm going to put a little damper in here, something that smooths out the movement of the seconds. And I'm going to use an oscillator. So I'm going to connect the output of the divide node to the oscillator and the output of the oscillator to the rotate pin. I'm going to tweak some values. And if you want to see how this node works, just select it and press F1. I'm going to set the filter time to 2 seconds. And the cycle per second also to 2 seconds. And now if I change 1 second, there's a nice shaky effect here. And I think it looks pretty cool. Now I'm going to put the same oscillator in between the minutes, because that's also moving a bit shaky. So I'm going to select the oscillator, hit Ctrl D to duplicate. And I connect it in between our minutes pin. Now, there's one thing you have to keep in mind. Normally in seconds, if I go past 95, it jumps back to 0. Now, if I double left click and I press 0 and I click outside, keep an eye on our little second clock hand over here. You see it moved very fast because it has to move all the way back from almost 1 to 0. And the way to fix that jumpy behavior is to enable the cyclic pin. It's now set to 0, and if I right click and drag up, it's set to 1. So let's test it again. I'm going from 0 to 95, and now I'm going back to 0. And it moves very smoothly. Now I also need to enable it here, of course. So I right click and drag up. And here you have our own little clock. Now it's time to introduce the time, and the node that does that is, I forgot actually, but I just type in time, and it is the node that gives us the current time is the current time node. How convenient. So I just select it, and our output gives us a weird number in, I think, days. That's not really what we need, but if I select the node and press F1, we got this help file, and you see that there is a Gregorian astronomy split node that splits out the time in seconds, minutes, hours, and all the stuff we need. So I'm just gonna select that node, hit Ctrl C to copy it, go back to my main page, hit Ctrl V to paste it, connect our current time to it. Let's move it over here. And let's find the minute pin, that's this one. The hour pin and the seconds pin. And here we have our own little clock inside VVV running all in time. Now, in my next tutorial, I'm planning to make some good looking textures so we can apply textures to our clock and make it look really cool. And also, you see here we got basically for the clock hands these groups of nodes who do basically the same. I'm going to show you a way to do it all in one go. It saves some time. We're going to work with spreads. It's how you're supposed to patch inside VVV. Well, my name is Wes Bam. Thanks for watching, and I see you all next time.